Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how you can combine Cubase and OBS Studio to record screen captures of what you're doing in Cubase so that you can use them in YouTube videos just like this. I'm going to show you how you can set up Cubase to properly route the audio. I'll show you how I set up my sound card, and I'll show you how I set up OBS Studio to record the Cubase screen, the Cubase audio, and this microphone all to the same video file. So let's go! So when I started this YouTube channel in May 2020, there were quite a lot of things to learn actually. Obviously, the home studio part, audio recording, I'd been doing that for quite long, but especially the video part of everything, I did not have a lot of experience with that. And one of the things that I found quite tricky to set up was the screen and audio capturing of what Cubase was playing. So that's why I'm recording this video, so you might get some benefit from it. And maybe if I forget how to do it, I can also have a look. Now, when you're talking about screen capturing for tutorials like this, there are actually quite a number of options for it. But in the end, I settled for OBS Studio because it seemed the most flexible, and I also saw a lot of people using this. So as you can see on their website, OBS Studio means Open Broadcaster Software, and it is a multi-platform program which is available for Windows, macOS, and Linux for video recording and live streaming. So you can basically just download it and set it all up for free. The only thing is, of course, that you need to learn how to work with it and how to set it up so that it does what you need it for. But let's first start with how I set up Cubase to make sure that the proper audio can get routed to OBS Studio for recording. Okay, this is a little Cubase project of my previous video, actually, in which I've started mixing just the snare, the kick, and the bass. So the idea is now that what I just played, I want to record it into my video. However, I'm using the control room. And if you look at my setup, you can see that I have SonarWorks on the main output of Cubase. Now, SonarWorks is speaker correction software. I have a separate video on how I use that in my home studio. But the point is that this software does correction for my listening environment. And I don't want to record this correction in the video because I want you to listen to the clean audio of Cubase without any speaker correction. And the main output of your PC may actually also get a lot of other sounds, like for example Windows desktop sounds or sounds from other applications. I don't want to record any of these sounds either. So what I want to do is I want to dedicate a separate pair of outputs on my audio interface that contains just the clean signal from Cubase. Now, in order to do that, we need to go to the audio connection setup. And what I'm actually going to use is the queue system that Cubase has. So I've set up one queue, Q1. Obviously, this way you can add queues or monitors or whatever. Now, as you can see over here, monitor 1 is my main output. That's what I'm listening to. And that's also the output that contains the speaker correction software. Q1 is the output that I'm going to send the signal to that I want to record. And then I'm sending Q1 to phones, which actually sends the signal to output 5 and 6 on my audio interface. Why I'm not directly sending Q1 to 5 and 6, I'll explain later. So let's have a look at what I actually sent to Q1. If you look at the mixer view, you can see that these are all my audio channels. Most of them are not in the mix yet. But at the very end, I have my stereo out master bus chain, and some of those effects are not in the mix yet either. But at the very end, you can see over here that the output of the stereo bus gets sent to Q1, and that's right before the output of the stereo bus also gets sent to the control room, in which I have my speaker correction software. So an exact copy of the stereo output signal gets sent to Q1. Now I will show you that this actually works. If I play something again, you can see that Q1 actually gets the signal. Now in the control room, you have to set the source of Q1 to QSense, which we just set up in the mixer. So let's see if this works. Now this whole setup works fine, unless you want to use the listen functionality of Cubase. And that's exactly what I want to do, because I actually use the listen button to listen to reference tracks because it doesn't go through the stereo out processing. And again, I have another separate video about how I do that. But the point now is that I want to use the listen functionality, and you can actually also use the listen functionality to, for example, listen to what's happening on your effect channels. But if I now mute drum and bass, so the main mix is not playing anything, you will see that when I push the listen button, this audio will go to the main mix. So on my monitors, I can hear the reference track, but it's not sent to the queue. Let me show you. Now playing the main mix, which doesn't contain anything. And now I'm pushing the listen button. And you saw that there's no signal in the queue, so the listen is not actually sent to the queue. Now you may also have noticed that the listen signal also got registered here in the phone section. Over here you can see in the phone section that you can enable the listen bus on this output. So the listen bus does get properly routed to the phone's output now. And that's exactly why I'm using that output to record into OBS Studio. Because during my tutorials, I may sometimes want to push the listen button and let you listen to either a reference track or to, for example, an effects track. Now, in order to make this work correctly, you have to, of course, configure in the phone section that you want to use as a source the queue, and you want to enable the listen bus for the phones. So summarizing, in the mixer, the stereo output gets sent to Q1. Q1 enters the control room over here. This is not sent to any hardware output. However, the phone section also gets a signal from Q1 and has the listen bus enabled. And the phone section is going to output 5 and 6 on my audio interface for recording into OBS Studio. So now I'm sending the signal that I want to record into my video to output 5 and 6 on my audio interface. How do I now get it back into OBS Studio, you may wonder? Well, there's really a couple of ways that you can do that. One is that you can connect the output 5 and 6 of your audio interface with a cable to input 5 and 6 of your audio interface, and then you can let OBS Studio record input 5 and 6, and that will then contain the output of Cubase. Obviously, it's not really a preferred solution, because what you're actually doing is you're going from digital to analog and from analog back to digital, so you get some quality loss. But if there's no other way, it is possible to do it like this. Another option is to use additional software that can loop outputs to inputs without going out of the box. And one example of that is VoiceMeter Banana. I think it's one of the things that Chris Sellum has mentioned a couple of times for this purpose. And I haven't used it myself, but I trust Chris. It'll probably work just fine. And I'll provide a link to that software in the description below. Now, another option, and that's actually the option that I'm using, is to use the internal loopback functionality in my audio interface. Not every audio interface has it, but my audio interface is by RME, and that one does have an internal loopback functionality. So let's have a look how I set that up. Now, this is the control panel of my audio interface. You can see that I'm recording here on channel 1. And on the bottom here, you're seeing the outputs of my audio interface. And this output, 5 and 6, is where I'm sending the signal from Cubase. Yeah, you saw signal on output 5 and 6. You also saw signal on some other outputs, the main output, and also on 3 and 4 for my external effects loop. But it is the signal on output 5 and 6 that I want to record into OBS Studio. And for that, I have the internal loopback enabled, meaning that anything I'm sending to output 5 and 6 will also appear on input 5 and 6. So that's the way I'm sending the Cubase audio to OBS Studio for recording. So let's now have a look at how I set up OBS Studio to record this Cubase audio, as well as this microphone and my screen. Okay, so what you're looking at now may be a bit confusing, because this is the window of OBS in front of Cubase. And I'm also using OBS at the moment to record my voice and this screen capture. And you're also seeing the screen that is captured, and that repeats in itself. So it may be a little bit confusing, but hopefully it's clear what's what. So first thing I have set up in OBS Studio is the following. On output and on recording, because I'm recording, you can see that I have enabled recording to 3 audio tracks, because one of them I will be using for the microphone that you're hearing. Another one I will be using for the Cubase audio that we just discussed. And the third one is my regular desktop audio that gets recorded. For example, if I want to play something via Spotify or any other program on my Windows PC. Now, if I then go to the audio tab, you can see that I'm recording on these tracks with basically the highest bitrate that I can set. And track 1 is for mic audio, track 2 is Cubase audio, and track 3 is desktop audio. Now if you look at the OBS Studio main screen, you can see that there are a number of sources defined here. And those are basically the things that I'm recording. You can ignore the sources which are grayed out because I'm currently not using those. But what you're seeing, I have defined as sources a mic input for my SM7B mic, which I'm currently using. I have a source for my desktop audio, and I have a source for my Cubase audio, and I have a source for my display, so that part of the display of my PC gets captured. But let's first have a look at Cubase audio. Over here in the audio mixer part, you can actually see what's happening on those various audio channels. So on the bottom, you can see that I'm speaking into the microphone. If I'm playing something on Cubase, you will see audio on the Cubase audio channel. And if I bring in Spotify and I play something on Spotify, you will see the desktop audio will register. Yeah, you're also seeing that on my microphone because I'm not using headphones. So my speaker signal is also bleeding into my microphone at the moment. Now, what have I set up for that? If I go to advanced audio properties over here, you can see again the three active audio sources that I have. Volume of everything is at 0. For mic input 1 and 2, currently OBS Studio records all channels in stereo, but on the mic input stereo channel, I only have the left side connected on my audio interface, so I tell OBS Studio that it's mono. And over here, you can see that the mic signal is recorded into track 1, Cubase audio signal is recorded into track 2, and the desktop audio signal is recorded into track 3 of the resulting video file that OBS Studio produces. Now, if you look at the properties of the Cubase audio, you can see that I'm basically recording the input 5 and 6 on my audio interface. And, well, I just explained how we routed the Cubase audio to that. Desktop audio, it says I'm using the default audio device that's defined in Windows. And for my microphone, you can see that OBS Studio will use the inputs 1 and 2 on my audio interface. Now for the display capture, it's a bit of a special story because I'm not actually recording my full screen. As you can see in this picture here, I have a widescreen monitor and I've set up Cubase and any of the other programs that I'm recording in these tutorials to only occupy the top left part of the screen, exactly at the size of an HD video. For example, if you look again at settings, and if you look at my video capture settings, you can see that I've set up a canvas of 1920 by 1080, which is exactly the left part of my screen because my full screen is 3440 by 1440. And I think this is the most suitable resolution for recording and showing screen captures so that they still show properly on all your monitors at home. And it doesn't really work if I capture in a very high resolution and your screen at home is not that high of a resolution. Additional benefit is, of course, that I can use the remainder of my screen to show, for example, my video scripts at the same time, or show my OBS window here on the bottom right, and even show the gate that I'm using here on the top right to make sure that my microphone signal is loud enough to trigger the gate. Now, and if I then want to start recording, I basically push the start recording button here. But since I'm already recording, it has been replaced by a stop recording button. And in this setup, OBS basically outputs a video file with three audio tracks, one stereo track with my mic signal, one stereo track with the clean Cubase output, and one stereo track with the desktop audio if I use that. So that's basically how I've set up my OBS Studio for these videos. Okay, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel and ring the little bell icon so you know when I post another video. And the next video on your right here is how I use the listen button to listen to reference tracks in Cubase. So have a look, enjoy, and see you soon.